A tomato hornworm,
so
if you grow tomatoes and
tobacco
stuff, you'll probably see them.
Hornworm.
There's his horn on the back.
Right there. Right, well, that's the back end of
that's
it.
That's the back end.
That's kind of deceiving. Which,
there he is.
Yeah.
So they, Sue has trained them to do this. Slowly. He's rolling over. Come on. Do a little better job than that.
There we go. Yeah.
There we go.
So you can see his head right
that's
there.
That's right.
You've got one on here, too.
Oh, I do. Where is he?
It's on your back right here. Blending in.
Very cool.
Yeah, they will turn into a sphinx moth, the Carolina sphinx moth.
Okay.
It looks a little bit like that.
Is that
bigger?
There? Oh, he is so cool.
Yeah. They're actually a major agricultural pest, however, yes. But they're good for the insects, too, because they're big and attractive and harmless and otherwise.
Yeah. Very cool.
So what kind of a cone do they form? A chrysalis? Do they form?
They form a pupa, actually.
A pupa.
So we grow them here. And we have a special enclosure for him that's got dirt about this deep. This guy will burrow under the ground and turn into a pupa.
Okay.
And then about a month later, he'll emerge as a moth.
Right.
Okay.
So, so moths typically do cocoons.
Cocoons or pupas.
Yeah.
It depends which kind.
Where butterflies do the chrysalis.
Exactly.
Gotcha.
Exactly.
Very cool.
Yep.
Uh-huh. Very neat.